I'll invite the congregation to please stand as we listen to the song On Eagle's Wings.
Gather together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. And today, as we gather, I do want to welcome you in as we fix our eyes on Jesus today, who is the author and perfecter of Justin's faith, as he was called by name in the waters of baptism, and as well as the author and perfecter of each of our faiths. So we look to him. On behalf of Cindy and George and Katie and Justin's family and friends, I want to thank you for being here today. Want again to celebrate the life that Jesus gave to Justin, but also to bring support and encouragement to his family as they fix their eyes on Jesus. I do want to encourage you, if you haven't checked already, if you would turn your phones off or silence them just so that we can keep those eyes focused on Jesus today. I hope that you got a bulletin. There are times throughout the service where you all will get to speak as well. Anytime you see the letter C with bold words behind it, we will all speak those words together. So we continue with the remembrance of baptism. In holy baptism, Justin was clothed with the robes of Christ's righteousness that covered all of his sins. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, that we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. The Lord be with you. Let's pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Justin and to all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And hear God's word as it guides us today. First from Deuteronomy chapter 31. Be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of them, for it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. And then from Isaiah chapter 40. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And then from the words of Jesus from Matthew chapter 5. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And also the words of Jesus from John chapter 3. For God so loved the world that he sent his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. It's God's word that guides us, our time today and into the future. And as God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ, living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. As we continue, we're going to listen to a couple songs back to back. First, I can only imagine where we look and we ponder what it will be like when we meet Jesus, and then we'll continue with Dancing in the Sky, and it's kind of almost a response of, it's good. It's good to be with Jesus. And so we continue by listening to I Can Only Imagine.
Thank you. forever worship you. I can only imagine
Justin loved adventure. Justin was an adventurous man. It may have started at Cub Scout camp, you know, climbing up the tree to zip line for the first time and getting up to the very top and saying, nope, and climbing back down. But really wanted to zip line, so climbing back up again, getting to the top, nope, climbing back down. But finally that third time, climbing back up to the tree, buckling in, and flying. And I think from that moment, getting the wind in his hair, he never wanted to not do that again. And so his life was filled with adventure, filled with opportunities to let the wind blow through his hair. George, you and I don't really know what that feels like anymore, do we? No. But Justin took full advantage, letting the wind flow through his hair. And as we were preparing for today, we were talking and really looking at some different Bible passages that not only fit Justin, but fit our time today. And Isaiah 40:31 was one of the first ones that came up. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They'll fly. Right? And that's something we're going to talk about in a little bit. But that's a day that we're still waiting for. That's prophesying a day when Jesus will return and will raise up all of us who are waiting for the Lord to renew our strength, where we will all, by faith in Jesus, all will walk and not grow weary, run and not faint. But that's the day that we're looking forward to. So what about today, though? What about today? John 3:16 is probably the most well-known Bible passage in the world. For God so loved the world that he sent his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. That's true for you and me today. And that's true for Justin. Jesus came to this earth for Justin. Jesus came to this earth for you. Right? Because we all are subject to the effects of sin. We all are aging. We all are, as the psalmist would write, wasting away. But Jesus came to fix that. And Jesus is coming again to fully fix that. Jesus is coming again to raise up Justin to new life. Jesus is coming again to raise up all those who have faith in him to new life. Right? In the waters of baptism, Justin was brought into this faith. And then he grew in that faith. He grew in that faith in worship. He grew in that faith throughout his days at the school, here at Trinity. And then he stood up here and he confessed his faith. The words that we read together earlier in the Apostles' Creed, he was asked, is this what you believe? Yes. I believe in God the Father, Almighty Maker of heaven and earth. Right, in baptism, Jesus called Justin by name, and then a little over a week ago, he called him home to him. And while we wish that time it would have been different, while we wish that was further down the road, as we heard in that last song, Justin would be saying the same thing. It is beautiful here in the arms of Jesus. There's no better place to be. If Justin were to come back today to stand up here and talk to you, the one thing that he would tell you is to fix your eyes on Jesus. To look to Jesus. Right, the author of Hebrews wrote, "Come, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God." Right, Jesus died an agonizing death for you and for Justin. And as he was hanging on the cross, again, the author says, "For the joy that was set before him, he endured that cross." And so as he hung on that cross, he pictured each and every one of your faces. He pictured Justin's face. And so he endured that death for Justin. He endured that death for you, so that he might spend eternity with you. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Right? We have a hope and a future. As we look forward to that day when Jesus will return to raise up Justin to new life. And because we know that that will happen, because we know that Jesus will return, today we can have a bit of that comfort. But we look forward to that final day. when Jesus returns, that we will be fully comforted because we will see Jesus, we will see Justin again because of the faith that he confessed. Be strong and courageous. That's written multiple times throughout the Bible. It was our theme verse here. It was written in a different verse, but it was our theme verse here at school this last year. We had it from Joshua 1:9. Be strong and courageous. Do not be dismayed. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. As you go throughout today and tomorrow and the next week and the next month and the years to come, God goes with you wherever you go. And so let the wind blow in your hair if you got it. You can go be adventurous. You can go live a life in creation. Go enjoy God's beautiful creation, knowing that God goes with you wherever you go. And knowing that Justin sees that all that more clearly today, as he is wrapped in the arms of Jesus, as he is clothed in the righteousness of Jesus, and as he sees Jesus face to face today and for all eternity. But like I said, Justin's still waiting for something new. You and I are still waiting for something new. In a little bit, we're going to read together. I'll read part of it and you'll respond, but we're gonna read a passage from Luke, or excuse me, I should get my books right, from John chapter 11. And in that passage of scripture, one of his best friends, Lazarus, has just died. And Jesus comes to Mary and Martha, Lazarus' sisters. And they're broken. And they're hurting. And Jesus weeps with them. But as he's talking to them, Jesus says to them, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will live, even though he dies. Whoever lives and believes in me will never die. And we see just a little bit later in that section that Jesus calls out to that grave and says, Lazarus, come out. And he does. And I believe Jesus had to be very specific there, saying, Lazarus, come out, because if he would have just said, come out, all of the graves would have been opened. Because that's the power that Jesus has. But that's also the words that Justin's waiting for. That's the words that all those who have gone before us in faith are waiting for. That's the words that we are waiting for, when on that last day Jesus will return with the sound of the trumpet and the twinkling of an eye, and he will say, come out. On that day, Justin will come out. The new and perfect body that can run and jump and fly like the eagle. At least on a zip line. What a glorious day that will be. So together we look forward to that day. But until that day, we look to Jesus, who is the author and perfecter of Justin's faith. And the author perfecter of our faith. Amen. And now may the peace that passes all understanding keep your hearts and your minds and your eyes fixed on our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. As we continue our service, we listen to another song, Go Rest High on That Mountain. Let us pray to the Lord, our God and Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in the communion, in one communion, in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church, in heaven and on earth, your light and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been, give to the family of Justin and to all who mourn comfort in their grief and assure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, we pray, in the midst of things that we cannot understand, to believe and to find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we ask that you would hear our prayer at the death of Justin, whose life passed so quickly, that in our deep sadness we may remember how short our earthly pilgrimage is and seek those things that are above, where Christ is seated. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And receive thanks, our thanks, for Justin, for all the blessings that you bestowed on him in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with him we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we will live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And taught by our Lord and trusting in his promises, we are bold to pray the prayer that he has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And then, as I mentioned, that passage from John chapter 11, where Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Let's pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock in the arms of your mercy, and you bring them home. Comfort us with the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life, and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died for faith. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And receive the blessing of our Lord. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. Amen. As we conclude our service today, we listen to one final song, and I have the words printed for you in the back of your bulletin. Carrie Underwood only sings three of the four verses, but I wanted you to have all of those. But pay special attention to verse 4. That's the day that we're talking about. That's the day that we're looking forward to. That's the day when Christ will come with a shout of acclamation and take me home. Take you home, take Justin home to that final place, that new creation where we will be raised up to new life. As we listen to How Great Thou Art. how great is that Savior that Justin has, that you have, that Savior who will on that last day come with shout of acclamation, and we will all say, my God, how great thou art. As the ushers usher you out today, we do have a meal prepared for you, a time to gather together and be reminded of the life that Justin lived, the adventure, the wind in his hair. And so we'd love for you to join us with that. And so as we're going to be eating together, let me take a moment and pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are here with us, and that you are a good Savior, and that you gather us into your arms and you bring us home. We thank you for gathering Justin safely into your arms. We look forward to that day when you will raise him up to new life and all of those who have faith in you. Until that day, Lord Jesus, though, we ask that you would give us your comfort and your peace. Today, as we gather around this meal, we pray that you would bless it, that time would be good and beneficial as we remember and share those stories and are comforted by those around us as we fix our eyes on you, Jesus. So again, we ask that you would go with us, as we know you always do, that we might not need to be discouraged or dismayed. We have no need to fear because you are with us wherever we go. May God continue to go with us each and every day. We pray this in your name. Amen. God's blessings to you today.